There is a lot of bad agi in this shape. So actually, before going to the large point here, which white played in the game, I would like to show a little bit of these agis and what was my intention to play here. One of the agis is to play this move. If white cuts, then black has this kind of... kind of move. Sometimes even very greedy play here, but probably is too much. But this kind of move is enough. Let's say, so first play here. Here. Now here. And what looked before like a white area suddenly starts to be like a black territory, so it's very dangerous for white here. Another tesuji which I found very interesting was this move. Looks very strange move, but can be quite powerful. If white make a mistake, for example, if white tries to resist here, black cuts, white capture, black attari, white play here and black play here. Even this move is sente, so white has to come back here. And like this, black makes quite nice thickness and territory in center, also in center, which is huge. If black wants to resist here, then white resists here, then black has this move. You see how important it is to use all this kind of kikashi we have for the agi of this stone. White has to come back. And now, severely cut here. Next, this capture is a problem, so white have to connect, but then black connects also. And again, we notice a huge problem for white in this area. So things here are not really how they look like. It looks like white have some territory here and black have nothing, but if black starts to play in this area, it can be a really huge problem for white. Another example is, for example, against this. Now black plays this. And some kind of continuation like this. His group will be quite easily alive. There's a cutting point here, but also... Oh, there was a stone here. Also, there is a big problem with this kind of agi, with starting with this move. Against this move, if white is bowing his head, black will make a huge profit in center by forcing white to connect on neutral points. So this is also very painful for white. So if you look a little bit deeper at this game, white have a very little territory, maybe under 40 overall on the board, while black have already close to 20 here, and here is very easy to make 20, so black is clearly ahead. On top of this, there is so many bad agis in this area that really white feels in too much trouble, too hopeless position. And here, if black wants to really close the game quickly, he should answer with all the time with normal moves. If white extends somewhere, and say, okay, game over. This position is really hopeless for white. But I tried more, as usual. In this kind of position, I always want to try more, but I get less. It's a really big problem with... it's probably a bad mentality of winning a good game, very difficult. Trying to find the solutions to win the good game in a safe way, but actually this is probably not the safe way. This kind of very natural move are the safest way to win. Well, I will go fast over this because there was something interesting that happened after. First of all, now black should just very simply go out in the center and just attack one of these two stones. As long as white makes zero territory in this area, black is winning very easy, no problem. This move also shows black this position, okay, I won, please let me go home. It's something like this, but with each move like this extra that black plays, starts to give chances to white. This declaration of I won when the game is not really won is very dangerous for black. And, well, if white plays something in the center, then black will just play one more move on the side, and, well, overall position, black is ahead in territory by a lot. White resists quite hardly here. He's looking at this Aji in the corner. He's looking to enter here. If this, then this kind of move. So black have to be very careful now. In a way, was this kind of exchange is almost never good. So in this situation, was really not good. I thought I was playing safe, but actually I was not playing safe at all. I mean, this was white's chance to come back in the game. Well, the fight from here continues like this. And now, to enclose the area here, it looks quite big. Black had also a choice to continue pushing and go out in the center. But my judgment, probably this time correct judgment, is that this is enough. Also, when white gets to play this move, his group become very strong. And for black to make this area now, it's difficult. There is a cutting point here. It's a big difference between this and black's jump. But in this shape, white play like this and extend to the side. Here, more or less, oh no, first of all, he played this. This is a little bit vulgar way of playing, but it's maybe effective in this shape because white have a bad Aji and he wants to resist against the black entering here. So anyway, black is quite happy to get good shape in the center. Now this is clearly territory. In exchange, white played here. And finally, some territory appeared for white out of nowhere. This is the fault of this kind of move, who was trying to run away, but give white chances. Well, anyway, the next black move is very big. If not, there is a lot of Aji. This kind of move is sent against the corner, so white can jump quite deep. Also, this kind of move is annoying, and this kind of move also is really big breach in the black territory. So this is okay. This is quite a big move. But next, everything started when white played here. In this shape, black should just connect. Then answer everything. If white comes back, there is a big weakness here. Then black just defends the corner. And like this, probably this would be quite an easy win for black, around maybe close to 10 points win. In the real game, again, black tries hard. This is a little bit, let's say, Tetsuji sometimes appears in real games in this kind of shape. The intention of black is if white cut, he will connect under. If white block, then he connects on top and all his stones are connected. Well, even this, it's quite profitable for white. He makes this in sente. But this was my intention anyway, to play like this. And in this shape, white played a move that made me think very long. I think for this move, I thought more than 40 minutes. This is quite a long variation, quite a long reading and complicated reading, but I think it's interesting, so I will just put it on the board for your pleasure, let's say. If black connects, black would like to connect. If black play like this happened in the game after reading for a long time. I was somehow afraid that my reading is not accurate because the sequence is very long and complicated. And the game was a good game for me. And if I miss something in this reading, I would lose the game in one shot. And this was also my psychological weakness, let's say. Black should connect here. White connects. Black has to capture the corner. And now white cut. The sequence here is one-way street. Now, if white come back normally from outside, black play here, and take liberty, and he win the semi easy.